Here is a device which is based on the phenomena of electrostatics. It stores electrostatic energy and it has created a revolution in the field of electronics to electrical level. Here we will see that how it helps, which we see in our everyday home appliances. We use these capacitors in our everyday appliances. You must have observed it in our fan, coolers, etc. Why we use these capacitors? Because they are acting as a power booster. As soon as we connect it to our AC supply, then you will observe that the spinning starts instantly. Now this capacitor, which you will see it here, I'll say that it is based on electrostatic phenomena. It stores charges, but the net charge on this device is zero, because the total charge, which is plus Q and minus Q, the total net charge on this device is zero. But since they are separated by a dielectric, so we will see that whether it is storing charge or not. So by directly connecting it to the supply, we will see that a cracking sound comes, and then we realize that the capacitor is charged. Now we cannot dare to touch the terminals of this capacitor. Here we'll see that as soon as we touch the terminals of this capacitor, the energy is released. The current which is released through this capacitor is called as transient current. Although you must have seen these cells also, supply a current, but the energy stored in the cells is much more than the energy in this capacitor. The current in the cells is due to chemical energy, and the current in the capacitor is the electrostatic phenomena. Now, if you'll see that these capacitor inside, it is two terminals which are connected to the body of the metal plates. Here we'll see that this is weather tight. When this is removed, and we see that this is a aluminium foil insulated with the material, because it stores charges, and you will observe that the aluminium foil, which is about 30 feet wounded in the body, it stores charges. And if you'll observe that this aluminium foil is of this nature, and it's a microfilm, and it is a two metal plates which are storing charges. Now, this is a capacitor which is called polar capacitors. They have the positive end and the negative ends. The leg which is longer is positive, and the leg which is shorter is negative. These are the non-polar capacitors. Any terminal can be positive, any terminal can be negative. These capacitors are also used in our electronic devices. They are called as electrolytic capacitors. The purpose of these capacitors in the electronic circuit is that they supply pure DC to our IC chips, and this brings up the efficiency of the appliances, electronic appliances. These are the polar capacitors, and if you'll see that on the body of these polar capacitors, it is marked negative, and by default the other leg is a positive. If you go inside it, these electrolytic capacitors are named because of the dielectrics placed inside into it. You will observe that these are the parallel plate capacitors, and these are the metals which are insulated through this material, which is a dielectric. And these are the plates which are storing charges, and these charges remain stored in this body of this metal, and whenever required, they are being discharged to the circuit. These are the two metal plates which are storing charges. Capacitor, it's a device that stores electrical energy in an electric field. It is a passive electronic component with two terminals. There are broadly two types of capacitor. One is polar capacitor. Polar capacitors are those which are having a positive and negative terminals, and non-polar capacitors are those which are not having any polarity. Either of the end of the capacitor can be used as a positive or negative. There are various types of capacitors. One is ceramic capacitors, electrolytic capacitors. They are based on the shape of the conductors as well as the use of dielectric in these capacitors. The internal structure of a capacitor, you can see it here, is contained of negative charge connections and positive charge connections. Along with it, inside the body is a dielectric, metal plate and aluminium sheet. What is the principle of capacitor? Principle of capacitor is that the capacitor works on the principle that the charge increases on the conductor when the earth conductor is brought near to this first plate. The capacitance of the capacitor is the number that tells you how good that capacitor is at storing charge. A capacitor with a large capacitance will store a lot of charge, and a capacitor with a small capacitance will only store a little charge. The unit of measurement is farad. Remember, capacitor is a device and capacitance is a physical quantity. The types of capacitors are named on the basis of the shape of conductors used. For example, it's a parallel plate capacitor, spherical capacitor, or cylindrical capacitor. On the other hand, we can also name them on the basis of dielectric used in the capacitor. They are electrolytic capacitor, paper capacitor, mica capacitor, or ceramic capacitor. The capacitors, you will observe that they are used in your home appliances, whether it's a fan, whether it's a cooler, or in your electronic devices also. These capacitors are extensively and widely used in our power grids. Without this, we could not transmit our electrical energy from one place to another place. These are the pics which will demonstrate you that how these capacitors are useful in the transmission of electrical energy from power station to your houses. Here we will specifically talking about the parallel plate capacitance. Remember, capacitance, once again, I am repeating it for the sake of repetition, that capacitance is a physical quantity which is defined as the ratio of charge stored on the metallic body to the potential difference applied across it. Once again, I would like to remind you that the positive charge and the negative charge both are having the same magnitude. That is why the net charge on the capacitor body is zero. And to define 1 farad, it is a 1 coulomb of charge stored in the metal plate when 1 volt of potential difference applied across it. Here are the diagrams or the symbols of the capacitor. This is a parallel plate capacitor. The second one, which you'll observe the line with a curve, is a polarized capacitor. Sometimes we used in the pictures as a thick plates, which are also polarized, and the capacitors which we use it in our radio are the variable capacitors. Working of a start capacitor. Why I am talking to you about the start capacitor? Because without capacitor, we cannot start our electrical motors. And that is why you have observed initially that as the capacitor was active, that is why the spinning of the motor did instantly. The starting capacitor works by accumulating a large electrical charge inside the capacitor. During compressor or other motor startup, the start capacitor releases its charge to give a voltage boost to get the electric motor. Now, in the capacitor, there is one very important, and that's a dielectric. What is dielectric? Dielectric are basically insulators which get polarized when they are placed in an electric field. Here you will observe in the picture that there is a red metal plate and a blue metal plate, and inside it there is a dielectric. Now the purpose of introducing dielectric between the metal plates is that they increases the charge storage. Not only this, in other words, we say that it increases the energy density of the capacitor. So a very, very small, tiny capacitor can also hold large amount of charge if there is a proper material, dielectric material is placed into it. Here, what is dielectric? Dielectrics are those insulators which changes the electrical property of the body. What is dielectric strength? This is a very important physical parameter. The maximum electric field that can exist in dielectric without causing the breakdown of its insulating property is called dielectric strength of the material. And every dielectric has a dielectric strength. Here you will observe that some of the dielectrics with their dielectric strength. What is this dielectric strength? Dielectric strength is an electric field. Here you will observe that the physical quantity dielectric strength is having the same unit as that of electric field. That is volt per meter, but commercially we call it as kilovolt per millimeter. As I told you earlier, that the dielectric plays a major role in the increasing the capacitance of the capacitor. So once again, for the sake of repetition, I'm telling you that the dielectrics are those insulators which changes the electrical properties of the substances, or other words, we can say that dielectrics are those insulators which get polarized when placed in an electric field. So now I will be telling you that in the capacitor, if it remains connected with the source and we introduce dielectric, then how the six physical quantities will change. Here we'll see that first, the capacitance of the capacitor will increase k times. Capacitance, once again I tell you, is a physical quantity and it is equals to q by v, or here it is equals to k times c naught. Whenever we say naught in physics, it means that there is no medium at all, it is vacuum or air. And if it is multiply by k, then we observe that the capacitance of the capacitor increases k times, and k is a dielectric constant of the medium. Second is charge. The status of the charge here is again increases k times, and so it increases k times initially. Third is a potential. When we talk of potential across the plate, then the potential across the plate remains the same as it was without dielectric, and it is constant. Now, after introducing the dielectric, the potential was the same as it was earlier when the battery remains connected to the capacitor. The fourth physical parameter is electric field. And here we again observe that the electric field across the capacitor plate is again a constant and it doesn't change at all. Now the fifth part is energy. Energy is an electrostatic energy, and this electrostatic energy is actually half CV square. Now what happens is to the C, when capacitance increases k times, the potential energy stored between the plates of the capacitor is also increases, and then it is increases k times. Here once again we talk of energy density. Energy density is one of the very important profile of the capacitor, because it tells us that how much energy is stored in that particular geometrical size of a capacitor, and that is why we call it as energy density. And this energy density is actually energy upon volume. And this energy, which is increased k times, the energy density, since the volume between the plates remains the same and only there is a change of the parameter dielectric, and so we observe that energy density is also increases k times. On the other hand, if the capacitor is charged and the dielectric is introduced, then we observe that the capacitance is increases k times. And capacitance is C, and it is not having naught, but rather we write KC naught. Once again, listen it carefully, that the naught means that there is no medium. Second, the charge remains same because there is no supply. The charge is same. The third parameter is the electric potential, and we observe that the electric potential decreases k times, and there is a drop in the potential. As soon as the dielectric is introduced and battery is not connected to it, the potential is dropped. Now it has a capacity to store more charge so that it can reach to the original potential. Fourth, once again, the electric field is again reduced to k times. Now, why the electric field is reduced? Because these insulators, which gets polarized when they were placed between the plates or inside the electric field, then what happens? They generate electric field opposite to the external electric field, and so the electric field E vector now is E naught by K. K remains a dielectric constant. Fifth is energy, and energy we write it by the alphabet as U. Energy is again half QV, or we say that energy once again drops to k times, and hence once again the energy density UD is also reduces to k times to the original one, and that is why here when the battery disconnected from the charge and the dielectric is introduced, rest decreases, only the capacitance increases.